and welcome to Totally Doctor Who. Hey, what are you smiling at? You expected to see a Dalek at the end of that, did you? Welcome to the show. It's a fabby one. Can I keep this hat, by the way? It's lovely.
Hey, these are the fans that were actually used in that last episode of Doctor Who. How cool is that? Also cool, the return of the Daleks. Scary as ever. But we're saving those till next time on Totally, because today is all about these lovely dancing girls. It's about feathers, it's about fluff, it's about the 1930s, which is why we have got head dancing girl Tallulah, a.k.a. Miranda Raison, high-kicking it into our studio. Bringing home the bacon, we've got some pig men in the studio, so no talk of applesauce. Writer of the Manhattan Double Bill, Helen Rayner, gives us the lowdown on writing a Doctor Who story. I go to New York to check out the real Empire State Building, as featured in Doctor Who. As well as that, part four of our exclusive Doctor Who animation, The Infinite Quest. And Team Totally take on a movement challenge. Find out exactly what that involves later. So if you were considering doing anything else, do not. We filled our TGR with a load of dance fans. Hey, guys!
Yay!
And look out, there's a pig man behind you, Kyle! Yay! It's a bit scary. And let's have a huge round of applause for Miranda Raison, who plays Tallulah in Doctor Who. Nice to have you here.
Thank you very much.
Let's talk about the episode you were in. It was 1930s, very stuffy, on the bacon butty. Very glitzy, very glamorous and showbiz. Would you like to have lived in that time period, maybe?
Yes, I certainly would have liked to dress in that period. It was amazing. Kind of Louise, the costume lady, and I had good fun.
Do our dancing girls make you feel at home then?
They were fantastic. I tell you what, they picked up that routine a lot quicker than I did as well.
I was going to ask you about that, because it's no ordinary acting gig, is it? You had to do all the dancing yourself, you didn't have a dance double.
Had to do it all, and they were all professional dancers as well, so they did pick it up amazingly quickly. They get shown something once and they just do it.
Did you have extra lessons then?
I had a few extra minutes, yeah.
It's about a week, wasn't it?
Well, yeah. 6 months. But it was good fun.
Really. And the singing as well in the show, is that your voice?
It is my voice, yeah.
You lured me in with your cold grey eyes, your simple smile, your bewitching lies. One and one and one is three. My bad, bad angel, the devil and me.
And so you're available for weddings and parties now?
All entertainment, all sorts. Yes, I'm available. It was good fun. And it was quite scary singing, because I hadn't done that before.
Really?
Yeah.
Did you know you could sing before you did the part?
No. I'd kind of done school choir type stuff, but not sort of bluesy.
You do smell nice. Sorry, he's obviously attracted to the scent.
Yeah.
Heard the toilet.
So you had to go for singing lessons, dancing lessons, but you didn't get to go to New York, did you?
No.
Are you going to rub this in again?
Because I did get to go to New York. Have you been to the Empire State Building in real life?
I have, yeah. We queued for a long time, but it was worth it.
I see. When you go with Totally Doctor Who, you don't have to queue. Check this out. I'm here in front of the world-famous Empire State Building, which you'll probably recognise as one of the star attractions on this week's Doctor Who.
Because look, the Empire State Building's not even finished yet.
It's one of New York's most famous landmarks. Built in 1932, it's an Art Deco design and was then the tallest building in the world. The Empire State Building is one of New York's top tourist attractions. Over 3.5 million people visit it every year, not including the 15,000 people that come here to work every day. And of course, as soon as you get here, the only thing to do is head up. These are some of the fastest lifts in New York. There are 73 of them on the go, getting the tourists to the top. My ears are starting to pop. Believe it or not, it's appeared in approximately 90 films, as well as Doctor Who, and I'm lucky enough to have special Totally Doctor Who access. 79, 80. This is me, my floor. So here we are, this is the top. I hope it is a clear day, because apparently I could see up to 80 miles, which is the equivalent of me standing at the top of Big Ben in London and looking all the way to the White Cliffs of Dover. Let's check it out. So many skyscrapers on the horizon now, but back in the 1930s, the main two buildings dominating the horizon would have been this one and the Chrysler Building over there, something which you can see in this week's episode of Doctor Who.
You have built all this.
That is the antenna. It's actually just a TV aerial, but it acts as a lightning conductor for the surrounding area. It's been hit over 100 times. And most importantly of all, it's actually the Daleks' secret base.
Dalek Bay, investigate outside. The Empire State Building must be completed in time.
There are so many more fascinating facts I could tell you, but one interests me in particular. Apparently, if you were to have a kiss up here, there's so much static electricity in the air, your lips would actually give off little sparks. So, quite fancy giving it a go. Oh, a girl can take a hint. Fine. I'll enjoy the view by myself. Good jobs, don't I? I've often thought being a writer would be a good job. Notebook, cups of tea, which is probably why Helen is in our cafe here. Aha!
Hello.
How many cups of tea have you had so far?
Enough.
Oh, secrets in there. Were you doing some writing?
Very secret.
Come and have a chat with me right now, because you did episodes 4 and 5. You haven't seen 5 yet. How important was it to leave us on that cliffhanger?
Oh, I wanted to write a cliffhanger where everybody was in a huge amount of danger, a huge amount of trouble, and we've got no idea how they're going to get out.
What is it? Human Dalek.
Bringing the Daleks back as well, was that pressure for you?
It was really strange, because I can remember them so clearly from when I was a kid and how scary they were, with the voices and the kind of the gliding role, and I wanted to get as much of that kind of childhood scariness into the scripts as possible.
To the transgenic laboratory.
Doctor!
And what about the pigmen? Are you happy with the way they looked?
They look kind of quite funny, but also quite scary as well, quite savage. I read a lot about the horrible squealy noises they should make and their little sharp tusks and their little kind of evil piggy eyes.
So well, they're here and they are quite scary.
Fantastic.
I reckon we're going to catch up, do some writing with you later. But right now, time for Team Totally. Would you excuse this? They've got a choreography challenge. That's more like Riverdance, isn't it? Here you go.
Welcome to Team Totally. Competing are Team Time Lord. They are Cody, she can do magic tricks. Alia, he can twist his tongue into a flower. Sarah, she likes to break dance. Up against Team Time Lord are Team TARDIS. They are Chris, he loves to annoy his sister. Molly, she can burp as she talks. Daniel, he's played rugby for Wales. For 12 weeks, our teams will have the opportunity to take 2 points for winning a task and 1 point for being runners-up. The team with the most points will win a money-can't-buy Doctor Who experience. Who will win? Only time will tell. Team TARDIS have won 3 tasks in a row. It's not looking good for Team Time Lord. Can they finally win a task in a choreography challenge? All the monsters and creatures in Doctor Who have a distinctive way of moving, and it's up to the choreographer to come up with those movements and give the aliens their character.
In a lot of the heads, they have got very, very limited vision. So we have to work out a process whereby they work as a team together and also to be very confident.
The process used to decide movements involves looking at pictures of the character's costume and its overall body shape. This, combined with script descriptions of the creature, provides the inspiration for the choreographer. Having created the unique movements of the Cybermen, the Slitheen, and the Clockwork Droids, Ailsa is the ideal person to set and judge today's task.
Well confused. This is our challenge, the Pig Guard from Daleks in Manhattan. How do you think this pig guard walks? He's part pig, he's part man. They are in the control of someone else and they are slavish and obedient. So he's pretty vicious, pretty nasty character. So have that element in the quality of your movement. Good luck, that's your challenge.
Okay.
Ailsa will be judging the teams on how they reflect the pigmen characteristics she's described. Working in different parts of the studio, the walk is the first thing the teams discuss.
Do you think that they should walk
slow, like, sort of like
a human, but a bit more agitated? fit a bit more, like, scruffy, like, more.
What do you think the walk should be?
I think if we just do it, like, one, two, one, two.
Yes,
one,
show us okay. What you kind of think you think it is.
Go on, then.
OK.
Alia has got into character very quickly, but Team TARDIS are still trying to find their motivation.
They're being controlled, but the thing is, like, their own mind right. is, like, trapped, so it's like sometimes they have like little jerks.
What should we have his hands like? Because that's his hands, but what where should we have them?
No, they can have it like that.
We're gonna have it like this and then
no,
like...
because they can't have it. Yeah, so they're gonna like.
I think it wasn't really limp, was it?
Yeah, but it's a sort of like a cross.
Yeah, yeah, a bit like
feet forwards.
Team Time Lord are fine-tuning their performance, whereas Team TARDIS don't know which way to move.
So they're a bit like that, really. And like they're less than playing, failing, whatever.
Yeah, because they're quite short. They're like this.
On this, it just says pigmen. Slowly advancing pigmen. It didn't say anything about normal, average human beings. So
yeah. Yeah. So
in the final seconds, it seems both teams are starting to get frustrated.
And then look up, sort of.
What are you doing? I don't have a clue what you're doing.
But that's going. That.
Team TARDIS, time's up, Molly, Dan and Chris. Can we see what you come up with?
Yeah, sure.
Good.
Will Team TARDIS have monster moves or have they made a pig's ear of the task? It appears Team TARDIS may have busted a move too far. Will Team Time Lord be three little pigs on the way to a win?
I'd love to see how you think the pig guards walk and run.
Okay.
Team Time Lords seem to have smoother movements. Could this be their first win of the competition?
But I think now what I've got to do is call back in the other team and then we have to decide who it's going to be today.
I think now we are going to keep our winning streak because hopefully to keep our pride up it's going to be 4-0.
I think our team did work well as a group and hopefully we're going to win today.
Who will win? Stay tuned to find out later.
I've been doing my own choreography, Barney.
Have
Watch
you?
This. What's this?
You've stubbed your toe.
No.
You really, really need the toilet.
No.
Oh, I know, it's me.
It is. It's you getting excited because you do, who goes there?
I can't believe you just said that. Everyone knows I'm the one that has to introduce it. It's the law. It's not my fault the government said so. Can I do it? OK, it's now time for Who Goes There?
Do the dance. See, I was spot on.
You were nearly there.
It's your chance to get hold of a totally sweatshirt, as modelled by Miranda and our pig men.
Very nice. Well,
a bit scary, actually. All you need to do is work out what alien or monster is behind our screen?
I'll go and show it to you. Cue the lights. Okay.
Oh.
He's very ickle.
Is he in the distance?
No. I am 6'9", but no, he's only a little one. Should I turn him around? So
yes, please. Okay. Sort of
come
weird
on.
Things
turn
going on with his hands so far.
On. Just a little bit.
Let's have a look.
Ah.
Oh, very interesting around the schnoz.
Thank you.
Can you work out what that is? If you can, you need to get in touch. The address is on the screen at the moment, or email us totallydoctorwho@bbc.co.uk. Good luck. And by the way, if your name is on the screen about now, you've already won yourself a Totally sweatshirt. Congratulations to you.
Now, though, it's time for the fourth instalment of our Doctor Who animation. Now, the quest for the data chip continues, which leads to the infinite. The Doctor and Martha find themselves on the planet Bukan, where the pirate Captain Calico is raiding the living oil rigs, and he's about to throw the Doctor and Martha overboard. Dun, dun, dun. I do me all sound effects and everything.
And breathe.
Thank you. Here it is.
So, Swarp is the real traitor in the Oil Corporation. Find out what happens next in their infinite quest.
I like the way you do that,
the infinite quest.
Listen, let's talk about Daleks. Miranda, are they as scary to work with as they look?
I did have one scary moment with a Dalek, actually, which was kind of on a tea break between takes. and I waved at a Dalek that was in the corner in the sewers, yeah. And it waved back at me with its plunger.
That's got to be a little intimidating, hasn't it, when the plunger starts pointing at you?
That teaches not to go waving at Daleks, though. I don't think they should wave at. They're not nice. By the way, if you love Daleks, we've got a Dalek special coming soon. I'm talking, keep watching for that. Got some questions for you now from the guy called Zoe. You got one?
Do you feel nervous when you're on TV acting, and is it strange or weird when you're acting with the pig?
I think you did very well considering you had pigs sniffing your face. I do get nervous. I get nervous on stage much more than on telly, and it's weird acting with the pigs. But I like my pig boyfriend, but he was nicer licking than that one.
Ooh, don't get him mad, that's all we need. That pig man going nuts. And you've got a question, Victor?
Would you like to have a pig as a pet?
Not if it looked like that, but if it looked like Babe, then maybe I would. I like piglets, but I call them the full-grown version.
We've been doing a bit of pig research. We've got some pig questions for you now. Right. You can join in as well. Do you want to start?
I'll start, yep. Okay. What is the name of the Hollywood superstar who used to have a pot-bellied pig as a pet? You do know?
Miranda Anybody knows. Know any there? Of you guys know?
No.
You've saved the day, hopefully.
Mr. George Clooney.
Oh, it is, yes.
You've saved their bacon.
Oh, no.
Second question. Moving on, O'Brien, moving on. Second question. What is the name of the pig in Charlotte's Web?
Oh,
Zoe. Hang on. Zoe?
Wilbur.
Wilbur is the right answer. Well done.
Who is the most glamorous pig in the world?
Gotta be Miss Piggy.
Of course it is.
Gotta be.
It is right. And your final question, what is the name of the lead pig in Jakers? What's the name of the lead pig in Jakers? Anybody?
No?
No. Do you know?
He's a mate of yours, isn't he?
It's actually Piggly Wink.
Oh, I was going for Eric. Close enough. Sounds like it.
You were talking about your pig boyfriend.
Yes.
Wasn't he renowned for doing something really weird pig-related?
Oh, yeah.
He was the state champion for pig calling when he was about 10 years old, and he entered a competition which was only adults pig calling, and he won it, yeah, at about 10. And he did this noise on set, which is the pig calling.
And it's not
cry.
A case going, come here, piggy. It's
no,
not
it's
that kind of pig calling.
Wee-wee, but much louder.
Oh, I thought it'd be like, ah! No, no, that's a bird noise. I was trying to do the pig squeal noise.
You did very well.
Can you
go? No, not a chance. Hang on. No.
And so then he does the noise and the pigs come running?
Yeah, apparently.
So it's sort of like a sheepdog
thing? I think he's meant to get them all into one contained area.
What a strange contest.
I know, but he won. That's the important thing.
We need you to do something quite spectacular for us now. Okay. It's not a noise, it's a hand print. We want you to join our Wall of Fame. It is over there.
Oh, wow.
Do you think you could join in and do a print for us? All you need to do is press as hard as you can into the clay there for us, please. Okay. Get going with that.
All right.
I can give you the info. You have 12 questions to answer to win all of these handprints at the end of the series. And so far, you've had 3 questions. Miranda is about to ask you the 4th question, if she can press hard enough. Have you got a print in there?
Almost, almost.
Tell you what, we'll set the scene to give you a few extra seconds. We need some mood lighting and some tense music. Good luck, Miranda.
What does the doctor secretly give to Martha before he goes to meet the Daleks?
She could be a baddie.
Good at that, yeah.
Thank you.
Nice.
Baddie. You need to watch the next episode of Doctor Who for your answer. Good luck with that.
Now, though, it's time for part 2 of the Team Totally Challenge. It was a choreography challenge. Who's won? I don't know. How about you?
I don't know what we're doing.
Our 2 teams have been competing in a choreography challenge in which they had to decide how the pigmen from Daleks in Manhattan should move. Team TARDIS did more talking than moving.
Like, their own mind is, like, trapped.
Team Time Lord seemed to get into character very quickly, and both teams got frustrated with each other.
What are you doing?
And then look at someone.
With the judges' decision seconds away, do our teams think they will win?
I'm quite confident about keeping our winning streak because we can work well as a team, and also, if we do, then it'll be really, really in their faces.
In each of the 4 tasks, we all thought we were going to win, but we didn't. So I'll be really gutted if we lose this one as well.
Welcome back. Team TARDIS,
you interpreted very well. You looked at the illustration, you took on board the words, and you tried out very individual movements, which was exactly what was needed, because there is nothing there that says they're marching together like the Cybers did. Very nice indeed. Team Time Lord, working together very nicely as a team, took on board the picture, took the stance, and even came up with the idea that the movement could be smooth and level. You've all done amazingly well, but the winner is... Team Time Lord.
Yeah! I thought it was quite easy, but now you know, like, never underestimate it, because when you think it's easy, you're probably going to lose.
I feel really happy that we finally broke that losing streak and won at least one task, because I feel that we worked really hard.
Team Time Lord take their first win of the competition and narrow the points difference to just two. Could Team Time Lord take over Team TARDIS' winning streak? Tune in next time to find out.
Oh, well done to Team Time Lord there. Now, Helen Rayner is here, who's written episodes 4 and 5 of Doctor Who. Where do you get your inspiration from when you're writing?
Well, everything around you is basically a giant box of tricks, so it's a good idea to take one object and think of something unusual or scary that it might do.
We've taken your giant box of tricks literally. We've got a huge toilet there. Oh, we've got a beach scene, we've got an old school desk, some little bits and bobs and an armchair. Let's have a crack at this story writing, shall we? Geoffrey, Angelina, do you want to join in? Will you start with the armchair, please?
Yes, then this is no ordinary armchair. This is a special digesting armchair. So Martha sits down here and it folds in on her and digests. And when it opens up again, Martha has gone, and in her place is just a little tiny egg.
Oh no, Martha is now an egg. Geoffrey, what's going to happen to her?
Well, Martha's going to go over to the toilet, into the toilet, lift the chain, and she's now scrambled egg.
She's scrambled egg, Angelina. What's going to happen?
We're going to take her over to the post office, post her, and send her to the doctor and see if he can help.
OK, I'll finish the story off. I'm going to take a leaf out of your book and leave it on a cliffhanger. You might want to get a cup of tea and find out what happens next week. That was good fun, wasn't it? I enjoyed that. Speaking of next week, would you mind drawing something from next week's episode for us? A little bit of a clue?
I will do my best. And if it doesn't look very good...
Some inside information here, Angelina.
Ooh. Should be a bit longer and thinner, but...
What do you think that could be? maybe lightning? I don't know. Ooh. It's very good to have a clue from the writer here, but I can go one better. I can give you a sneak peek of the next episode of Doctor Who.
The Doctor has escaped!
Then find him! Find him!
Find the Doctor! The prisoners must be recaptured!
Oh, how great does that look? Hands up, who's going to be watching? Yeah, me too. Go on, Miranda, tell us how it finishes. Go on.
Can't.
You know you want.
I can't tell you anything.
How about giving us a special announcement instead, then?
Oh, I would love to say hello to May, Izzy, Mia and Soph, please.
You've just done it. Thank you.
Thanks very much for being here. Thanks as well to Helen, to our pig men, to you guys, and to our dancers. See you soon. Bye! Yeah.